We're talking with Brenda Strohmer, the Liberty High School field hockey coach, who is the Varsity Sports Network 2019 Field Hockey Coach of the Year. Coach, Liberty finished off a perfect season with the Class 1A state championship and the Varsity Sports Network number one ranking. What was it like to finish off an 18-0 season with just about perfection?
It was awesome. It was a lot of hard work. The girls really set the goal to win and be undefeated. So to finish it with a state championship and be undefeated, it's awesome.
You've been to the state final four straight times with three state championships. So what drove this team to be the one that finishes 18-0?
Hard work, perseverance, setting the goal again. Like we said, we set a goal each year. I mean, it was baby steps. The first year we won states, it was to win states. We didn't care about our record. Then it was to win counties last year, because winning counties in Carroll County is huge. So this year we said, we want to accomplish all that, but also be undefeated. So it's just that they set that goal and they work hard, and it's the perseverance and the attitude.
You started off the season as our number 17, as 7 team, and worked your way slowly but steadily up to the number one spot. When you look back, can you pinpoint one key game or one key moment that really drove the rise to number one?
I feel like there's a couple key games. Where we knew we could do it was we beat Delaney in overtime after beating Merritt's Ridge in overtime in a tournament, back-to-back games, and the girls were exhausted. And they still pulled out that win.
Those two were state championships.
Right.
Well, Delaney was runner-up and Mary's Ridge was.
Right. So that was when they knew if they worked hard, they could do it. And then beating McDonough in overtime on a 2-1 with the goalie, it's just those were the key points in our mind that win. But, I mean, just beating everybody in our county is huge.
Well, with the win over McDonough, you beat them on October 1st, which was just a few days after they had beaten Garrison Forest, which was the number one team. So what did beating an IAMA conference contender mean for your team as far as confidence and skill and what they were able to go on to accomplish?
Well, McDonough's been wanting to play us for a couple of years, and I kept saying no, Finally, the girls were like, we want to do it. We want to play them. It's like, all right, we'll play them. And so I said, so we went into that with, we want to stay undefeated. We have to play hard. We know they're good. So they just went in there and they just played their butts off. And it was good. It was amazing.
Now, you also needed overtime to beat South Carroll in the playoffs. And they were the 1A champion last year, and you
Correct.
Were the 2A champion last year. So how about a tough game like that when it came to getting into the final against Washington, which was another tough team that you beat 2-1? How much did these close games during the regular season help you pull out that final one, do you think?
I think having all these close games, South Carroll's always a tough game. It doesn't matter if it's regular season, playoffs, or whatnot, but it's just that's the game. I used to coach there. I used to teach there. So for me, it's that. And the girls are tight friends with all the girls on that team. So to pull that win out and then to get to play that tough team at the state final, it just helps us. Each tough game just makes them better. And they're conditioned and they're ready to go. And I can sub any time to give somebody a break. And I'm confident in that.
Now, you won the state championship last year, and this year our expectations are really high, having been to the state final four 3 years in a row. So how do you as a coach help your players to deal with that level of pressure, which I'm sure gets higher the more games in a row you win?
I keep telling them that, last year we weren't expected to win. We were the underdogs. To beat Glen Ellen, to beat Hereford was huge. And this year I told them, I said, now we're not the underdogs. We've got the target. So how are you going to handle the target? And they handled it with grace. Every game they played with heart, and I think that's how we coach. You got to handle it. You got to do your best. You got to leave it all out on the field. You don't want to be like, oh, I wish I would have did that. And that's kind of how that went.
You've been coaching at Liberty for 9 years. Early on, you didn't make it to the playoffs, and Liberty hadn't won a state championship since 1982. So you built this program, but how do you as a coach adjust as the expectations change through your program and getting them to the level where they are now?
Well, when we first started, we were teaching X's and O's. We were teaching the basic stick skills. Now with the rec leagues and the club teams and all that, I get the girls, I don't have to teach the stick skills. So we can go into the upper level and, practice harder corners, do harder tasks. And so that's kind of how we play. And we coach we practice game to game. We don't ever think about what's next week. We don't ever think about what's 2 days down the road. We think about whatever game we have at hand, and we coach and we practice to that game. And I think that helps us because we try to play each game as it comes, and we don't think ahead. We never think ahead. And that's why I tell the girls, stop thinking ahead. Because last year we thought ahead and we almost lost to Manchester Valley.
Who are some of the key players who were instrumental in driving this state championship?
I have what I call my Fab Five. Christine Getz, Megan Huey, Caroline Evans, Kaylee Ward, and Caitlin Zarco. And then in my goal, I have Michaela Bull. Now, Michaela, on any other team, would have been a starting varsity goalie for 3 years. But since I had my good goalie that I had, she just backed up to her. And this was Michaela's year to shine, and she had 6 goals scored on her in 18 games. I can't remember how many shutouts. But that core group of 5 girls worked so well together. 4 of them were captains. And then Caitlin Zarco is only a sophomore, but her stick skills are, she knows the game. And then Megan Huey's leadership, Christine's determination, Caroline's hunger to score. So with all of that together, they just were awesome.
Hey, after the perfect season, what's next?
Another perfect, well, I did, it was kind of funny on the bus ride home. I said, well, now that we've had a perfect season, how about a shutout season? And I looked at my goalie and she just was like, because I'll have a new goalie. And she just kind of looked at me. You know, we want to keep it up. We just want to keep up the Liberty traditions of having a good field hockey team. We want to get back to the States. We want to win States again. We want to stay dominating in this county because Carroll County field hockey, like I said, is awesome. If we can dominate in our county and go on to win States, we can't get asked for more.
Thank you very much, Coach. Congratulations on the state championship, the perfect season, the number one ranking, and being Varsity Sports Network's 2019 Coach of the Year.
It's a team effort.
Thanks, Coach.